Hello.
Hi, how are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
I am very well, thanks. And I am Kieran. What is your name?
All right. My name is Megha. I'm from India.
Okay, cool. It's very nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
Cool. So, let me see. Oh, wow. You are totally new on Cambly? Yes, no, maybe.
No, I have already two or three sessions with other tutors.
Oh, well,
But this
sure.
is the first time I joined Cambly.
Yes, I got it. So you've had three sessions already. So and I see we are looking at an IELTS lesson. So you're planning on doing IELTS?
No. Currently, I'm not looking for that. Previously, I searched for IELTS, but we can talk in a general way, I think so.
Okay, cool. So, I really like to understand my students. You started using English recently, or no, not that you started using English recently, no, but recently you made a decision. You decided, I must improve my English. Maybe I need more speaking practice. Maybe I need more opportunities to speak with native speakers, or I want to feel more confident with native speakers. And you started using Cambly. So I want to know why. Why did you do that? Why is this very important for you now?
Okay, so whatever you are saying, all thing is perfectly, means I can say true.
Okay.
Because I joined Cambly, of course, to be more friendly whenever I talk to some strangers people. And I'm not that fluent at English. I can speak English, but whenever I talk to someone, that time I feel a little bit nervousness or hesitation, you can say like that.
Sure.
So yeah, for that reason I joined Cambly. Yeah, and what happened in here means our country, there are lots of people, they know English very well, but where if you are a beginner, so there is no that much of an opportunity you have that you can talk on the regular basis. You can means however you can talk with your friends, but whenever you talk with your friends, that is just random talk. No one will be correct you that you are speaking right or wrong. And apart from that, you don't have any kind of pressure to improve yourself
Yes.
because we know they are our friends, so
Yeah.
don't have any issue. And
Absolutely.
one more thing that when we talk continuously to someone, means one people, so after a while we are comfortable with that, with him or her, right?
You are
so
very, yeah,
so
totally
we
right.
we take we take like take for granted, and we are not focusing to improve our English.
I'll tell you what, you not only do you take it for granted, you start to read the other person's mind, my wife can finish my sentences sometimes, so
Yes.
yeah, so there I understand there is often less pressure to communicate in a clear way.
Yes.
So but now, having said that, this practice is good. Every time you can speak English with a friend or whatever, even without pressure, do that because it is always a chance to remember a word that you have not used in a while, to kind of think about a subject that maybe you have not spoken about in English for a while or whatever. So I do certainly think it's good practice, but yeah, it's not the only practice that you need if you want to really improve. And so what about that? Is English important? You have a perfectly good language and a perfectly good culture. Why is English really important?
Yeah, I think so, because English is not just a language. English is skill also. Means if you know, if you are good enough at English, or sorry, I don't know at or in,
So that
frequently I confuse with these words.
prepositions, they look, they are even advanced learners, they mix up these words because really there is no logic there. If you ask why for that, well, I don't know, it just is. So
Yeah,
anyway.
it just happened, always happened with me. Currently, I'm working on it. So yeah, so English in our country means if you say in a global perspective, means globally, English language is how can I say? Means it is means all over the world, English is spoken,
Yes.
and if you really want to explore all the world, so you have at least one language that you can communicate with people,
Right.
right? So English is that language, in my opinion. Apart from that, if you are looking for a job perspective, so also it is very important because in our country we have two official language, Hindi and English, right? So if you are looking for means if I Hindi is our official language, means our mother tongue, I can say. So there is a restriction if you know only Hindi. But I'm not saying that I don't love Hindi. Hindi is a language that I'm very comfortable, right? But when I talk about English, so English is giving lots of opportunity that we can do whatever we want and anywhere, not only our country, we can do all over the world. And if you are lover to meet different peoples, to know different cultures, so I think English is a way to relate with people all over the world.
Got it.
I think
Got
so.
it. Nice. So first I'm going to compliment you. I'm impressed. You spoke for a couple of minutes there, and you were very coherent. If we were doing an IELTS lesson, you would be showing some of the signs that I really want to see. So I am impressed. However, I feel like I'm talking with the British Foreign Minister, maybe. Oh, English. Yes, English is great. You will have opportunities in your life and you can travel the world and you can know a culture. I want to know about you. So if you reach that high advanced level of English, what is it going to change your life? What's going to happen?
It will definitely change my life because if I miss my personal wish that I could be one day I could be a very fluent English speaker. I'm passionate about that language, not only for job perspective. I love to learn English. Means how the people can very comfortable with this language. They speak with a good attitude and at the same time with a good pronunciation. So whenever I look like I am watching TV shows and I am watching English news and the anchors the way they speak with a fluent manner. So I am very impressed with that and I want to be look like that. So this is my passion, you can say, or you can say like I love to learn English. I'm very comfortable with this. So a job perspective, I can say it is more important for me because I will be able to go anywhere. Means what is my dream? I achieve my dreams. And what you said means if you are good at English, so what will you will do?
Yes, I will explain my question. I often speak with I sometimes when I ask these questions, students, so why was that important for you? Why did you start to learn English? Or why did you start to use Cambly? I want to improve my English. Oh, okay. Is English important? And they go, oh, maybe. Like some people don't even know why they are doing it. With you, I can see it. I can very clearly see that, you know, why you are learning English. It's not only about, oh, well, you know, we have many opportunities to travel the world. No, you have your reasons. You know what you are doing. And that's what I want to see. So do you work? Do you have a career already? What is your area? Or what are you
doing? Yeah, by profession, I'm a teacher. Yeah. I teach small children.
Nice. What do you teach them?
Actually, I teach all subjects in primary level. Hindi, English,
of course. Yeah, like
social science,
mathematics. So nice one. And do you plan on, you say you plan on traveling, do you plan on living abroad?
No, not like that. I just want to visiting new places, not that kind of plan for to settle in other country. I love my country and I'm perfectly okay.
Can I ask you?
I wish that I could be goes abroad like your country, Italy.
Nice. By the way, I've spoken with a number of Indian students here on Cambly, and I've never asked this question. I love Indian food, the type of Indian food that we find in restaurants in Ireland, like korma tandoori, curry, things like that. Do you guys regularly eat these foods?
I didn't get you what food's name you are saying, because I have a little bit problem to understand your accent.
Sure. Like, for example, one of them we call korma. It's a type of curry that's made with a coconut base sauce. And there's a tandoori is another one, which is a bit stronger. And I am a huge fan of these foods. I live in Brazil now, and the Indian food here is just not good. So I don't eat it. But I was just wondering, do you eat these types of foods regularly?
Yes. Personally, if you ask me, I am not that girl which eat too much spicy food. I'm a vegetarian.
Okay.
Yes. So I love to prefer eat fruits more than kind of dishes. Sure. But yeah, India is a huge country and we have a different kind of people in our country, different religions, and their food also making by different way. We use different kind of spices. You know, I think that Indian people love to eat spices food, chili, different kind of chili there.
Yes.
So
nice.
Yes. So, and especially if you go northern part of India, like Delhi and other, this kind of part. So, you see that there are lots of food and people are very foodie in our country. People love to eat different kind of things, different kind of foods. And yes, I can say we are very spicy kind of people. We love to eat spicy food and be the
I certainly appreciate that. I would love to visit and eat the real thing sometime.
And apart from that, we have a different kind of vegetables also. Even I think the world don't know about that. Like I came from Chhattisgarh. My state name is Chhattisgarh. So Chhattisgarh is famous for Jamaican, the name of vegetables.
Jamaican, like Jamaican. The country.
Yes, Jimmy Kali.
We're out of time.